Hello everybody, welcome to this webinar about how to design, manufacture and market brilliant luminaires thanks to Optis software solutions. We humans don't see the objects with our eyes, but we see the light interacting with the material of the objects. This simple physical principle is at the base of Optis philosophy. Optis is a virtual prototyping software editor. Optis creates virtual environment where light and materials perform exactly like in reality, following optical properties. In our virtual world, our customers are able to experience virtually their product exactly like if they were in reality. I'm Cédric Bélanger, Product Marketing Manager, and Julien Duchesne is Business Developer in the lighting industry.
Hello.
We will start with a few words about the future of light. Then we will overview the solution, making you imagine, design and experience your luminaires virtually. And finally, we'll discover why Optis virtual prototyping supports the revolution of the smart and human-centric lighting. The world needs more light. The world's population is expected to increase by 1 billion by 2025. Developing countries need more light. The world is more urban and digital. There is a need for innovative solutions to meet the future demands of city living, dynamic, intelligent controls, lighting on city-wide scale. To answer these needs, the LED have already revolutionized lighting. As you can see on the forecast from Lighting Europe, we are at the beginning of the intelligent lighting system development. The goal is to provide light precisely where and where it is needed. And soon, you will have to answer the need for human-centric lighting. At home, in the transportation, at the office, web-enabled LED lighting system will bring new experiences to help people relax, read, concentrate, or energize. Human-centric lighting increases performances and well-being all along your daily life. Julien Duchesne will explain now how Optis solutions help you to address these challenges.
Thank you, Cédric, for this kind of introduction. So today we will discover how the Optis solution can help each of us during the whole life, all the steps of a lighting project. So first we'll start to imagine. So why imagine? So we need to specify at the beginning of a project, we need to specify the right light we want. So the right light at the right place, good color, which power, which intensity distribution. So we will discover our imagine solution. So then we will go through an update of all new functionality, all new capability we bring in our software to design the luminaire, the lighting fixture. How the Optis solution can help to quickly shorten the design process and help to improve the lighting performance thanks to plenty of optimization tools for the design itself. And then we will finish by the experience part, how the Optis solution can be used in order to visualize a luminaire, again, based on virtual prototyping, and also to experience in real time with real time calculation the lighting condition in several scenarios. So first of all, we'll start with the imaging part. So the imaging part is dedicated to presskeeper and to designer. So our solution, it's a virtual reality, real-time solution in order to create together, presskeeper and designer, to create together the specification. So for that, we will go through a live example in order to show you how we can create in a collaborative environment with light specifications.
So I play the prescriber. What is the prescriber?
So you will play the prescriber. So typically an architect. Correct. So just an end customer for a lighting project. So let me present you this interface. So here on the right, you can visualize what Cédric is seeing in the HMD. And on the here we have a specific interface where we can play, we can play with the light, move the light and the object. So here the scene, the path is already illuminated, but the point of this step is to start from scratch, from the white paper, from nothing, and to put some light where we want in order to create together the specification. I am the lighting engineer, so I am responsible to develop a lighting feature, and Cédric, he needs some light in the past. So together, we will discuss and we will define the specification for the lighting feature. So first, I will switch off the light for Cédric, so the light we put in this scenario. And now I will switch on another light here. Okay. So we will start again the experience. Just a couple of seconds.
If it takes too long, we can come back afterwards, no?
Yes.
Just to the design, and then at the end we will experience the imagined part.
Okay, so just let me a couple of seconds, and if not, we will switch.
Okay. Okay. This is real. Okay, you sure, Julien?
Yes, yeah. Just okay. Give me 2 seconds.
Maybe a question? There is a first question? No? Okay, it's starting. Can see. No. Okay, now let's jump to the design.
Yeah, so yeah. Just to let me know if you see it. It comes.
Okay. Oh, yeah, it's okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay. Okay, so here you have a luminaire, so it gives an homogeneous lighting distribution. But okay. with our new solution, you will be able to define which light you want at which area. So now, here, on blue, it's all the zone in the scenario where you can put some light. And in red, it's where it's not possible to put some light. So now I will switch off a brush. So like a paint, and now you will be able to position, to place some light where you want some light. Okay, so here, just, you can paint, okay, you can now paint.
Yeah.
Okay, so here we see that Cédric is defining the lighting he wants. So here he is drawing the illumination distribution. So he's drawing the illuminance, but in fact is drawing in real time the IOS we expect for the source. So if I take another one of you here, we see that the luminaire is positioned here. Cédric is putting some light on the floor. So Cédric, you can still continue to paint. So here, Cédric is defining the best lighting for him. But we can also define the power. So Cédric, maybe you can tell me, for your experience, do you prefer to have this level of light, or do you prefer to have this level of light? So we can define together the necessary flux, but yeah. We can also define some color. So here, typically, I can switch from a warm white or a warmer white. And after, again, in a collaborative discussion, we can define together the intensity, we can define the flux, and we can define the color of the lighting fixture. So here, again, just to sum up, starting from a white paper, from scratch, you can define with your customer, or a prescriber can define alone, the specification for the lighting designer. He can specify the IOS, which is the output, in fact, of this software. So the output will be an IOS, a flux value, and a color specification. And now, Cédric, me, we can pass this specification to the optical engineer, to the lighting designer, in order to develop a luminaire. So for this part, I'm pleased to welcome Étienne Lesage, which is one of our specialists of optical development, especially for luminaires, and he will explain us how our solution, Speos, our CAD integrated solution can help you to shorten the design process. So how it can help you to design, develop a luminaire in an efficient way. Yeah, Etienne, please.
Okay, so starting from the IES, you just developed using the light painting. We have different approaches. The first one would be starting from components from the shaft. And it's always a struggle when you develop optical components to use those parts, mainly because you don't want to give away your IP. So we developed what we call the spouse components. And this component actually allows you to use your components in a design, do your characterization, but without having to give away your IP. So here I start from the lens, and from this lens I create what we call a spherical component. So that's a mesh. That's basically a mesh.
So what you mean in this situation is a component, a manufacturer create a lens.
Yes.
And if you want to use this lens in simulation, we can just access to the surface for simulation, but
exactly.
We don't have access to the IP. We don't have access to the full definition of our design.
Exactly. You cannot do operations with the CAD, but
okay.
You can use the parts as an optical component.
Okay. So typically, we have access to some library of components, lenses, reflector from the major components maker, and we can directly drag and drop and use it for our simulation in these CAD environments.
Exactly. So
okay.
the same for sources. So we can use a spouse component made out of sources. And so here I, in this example, I assembled both components and I was able to run a simulation and actually characterize the system in terms of intensity distribution. So that's the first way of doing that. The second way is more automatic and is...
Okay, so here, these capabilities are really dedicated to the to those who want to develop or want to create some luminaire based on assembly, based on the assembly. So they purchase some components, LED, lenses, reflector, and they can assemble
exactly.
And make an assessment of the performance
yes.
of that. But, of course, now how we can work to develop and to create our own optical components.
So you have different ways to achieve this goal. The first one would be to use the CAD software. And for those who are not really familiar with CAD software, we have the optical shape design family. So it's really a tool set of features that will permit you to create faceted mirrors. Lenses, different kind of shapes, actually, really
okay.
Based on optical description of the shapes.
Okay.
So
okay. So these capability is really helpful for the non optical expert. So without an optical background, within a few clicks, I think it's what you will
yes.
show us. Within a few clicks, you can have directly some well-known optical components developed, designed in the CAD environment again.
Exactly. So,
okay.
For instance, here I want to develop a faceted mirror on top of this surface. So I will just create what we call an optical surface. This will be the location of my source. I will use then this surface as a support, and this axis here. To project my grid and orientate it like this. Then I will just set up different parameters to actually achieve my design.
Okay, so here we see that we have X max, Y
so
max, Y
prime.
Really so here, let's say without something like 10, with something like about 10 parameters, you can develop automatically some complex optical components. So here it's a real time-saving feature.
Yes.
Like for a mechanical engineer, it takes, let's say, hours to create such pattern.
It could take some time. Here, what you saw is that in 2 seconds, I have a first version of my my mirror.
Okay.
And then I can move to the complete system like this. Okay. So here I did. So what we forgot to mention is that this shape I just created is 100% compatible with SolidWorks.
Okay.
So it's native SolidWorks geometry, meaning that you can do operations, Boolean operations with the geometry, assemble it to make it more complex, like this part I show you here. Okay.
Okay.
And then you can assemble your bits and pieces of optical components.
Okay.
Either from the shelf, either handmade, and perform the optical characterization.
Characterization. So
yes.
When you mean characterization, so of course, like a Speos, it's a ray tracer. You have access to illuminance simulation, intensity
yes.
simulation. So the output, it's a comprehensive photometric report based on a ray tracing
yes.
plus some IOS LumDat file.
Exactly.
For the luminaire. So we have a complete virtual prototype with a full photometric report.
Yes, so here for instance I'll show you a ray tracing. You have the intensity map around the system and you can see that here this spot corresponds to where the light will be redirected. Here this is at the back, this is where we don't really want the light to be redirected. So then I can go a little bit deeper into the analysis and make what we call light expert analysis. So this is the same map I actually project on the plan here, and I just highlight the path of the rays in this area here, and you can see that those rays correspond to where the light does not hit the facets. I can actually move to another area. This is the area of interest, and you see that the light is then hitting the facets and is redirected in different directions. So that's the first aspect. Another aspect is to really filter on specific facets, so specific geometries. So I change a bit the label. You can see that I'm really focusing on this particular facet here.
Okay.
And it corresponds to this intensity distribution. I can move around and observe the light behavior on the different facets.
Okay. So it looks like a very powerful tool in order to help to understand the light, the ray behavior in the system. From your opinion and from your experience, is it a tool for optical specialists or is it a tool for a non-optical specialist? So what would be your advice regarding that?
Well, this tool is quite easy to use. So that would be for beginner,
okay.
but also for advanced users in order to really highlight where the defaults
okay.
come from and correct.
Okay, so for beginner, it helps to understand
yes.
the basics of optics with a comprehensive ray tracing, but also for the optical specialist, he can help to fine-tune the design by identifying some hotspot or dark spot or some issue in their design.
Exactly.
Okay.
So here, the same kind of analysis on the 3D map. So that's the 3D map of the circuit geometries. And what you can see is that here again in 3D and in real time, I can actually focalize on this area of the reflector and see, observe all the light interactions on it. Okay?
Okay.
So there you are.
So with this 3D sensor, you can understand where is focused the light on the surfaces, etc. So you can also understand where are the most important surface areas in a component when you need to focus your attention
exactly.
for the development.
Yes.
Okay.
So once we have done the design, we characterize the design. What's really important and quite useful is to actually put the design into context. So once again, we use the CAD software to put the actual product into context and observe this kind of illumination on the floor, for instance.
Okay. Okay. So you start with the LED and the lens itself,
yes.
but at the end you can also produce a full map for the same scenario we saw
exactly.
before in the park. You can also have the illuminance distribution
yes.
for that and check. Regulations
exactly.
and performances.
Exactly. So you can actually check the performances against regulation and so on. And this is not all I wanted to say about it is really you can also play with the color of the light. Okay, so for instance, here I placed RGB LEDs on the system, and what's really interesting is that I can actually observe my results in true color.
Okay, so here you are using some RGB LEDs in the luminaire, okay?
Yeah. I can also observe the color coordinates, okay. So in X, Y, Y, for instance. And more, even more, I can actually play with the level of RGB. So okay. For instance, I can cut the green channel or can cut the blue one to make a range. And I can then decrease a bit the level of green and so on.
Okay.
Yeah.
So here you can work on the color mixing in order to
you can achieve white, for instance.
Okay, to achieve the right level.
So that you can play with the different channels in order to achieve mood lighting, for instance.
Okay, so you work on mood lighting scenarios.
Yes.
You can discuss also, I assume, with electronic or the people from driving in order to make sure you use the right intensity for each chip.
Exactly.
LED.
Yes.
Okay, but no, you are speaking about color. But what about we know that now in lighting there is more and more lenses, but
yes.
Lenses produce some chromatic aberration when we can see some blue halo or such an effect. Is it something we can simulate also with Speos?
Yes, exactly. So here I've got another example where I simulated a phosphor LED.
Okay.
So you can see that if the phosphor concentration is not good enough, you can have color shifts from right at the center to something bluish at the side.
Okay.
So this is something we reproduced a bit, playing with the different pigments concentration.
Okay.
And what you can actually see here, again, doing a colorimetric analysis, is that...
So typically, here it is a beam of lenses.
Yeah, for instance. And moving away from the sensor, you see the color shift.
Okay, so we have a value, we can visualize that, and we can know after, with the light expert, although understand why we have this kind of aberration and look for the best modification in the design.
Yes.
Okay. Something else to present about before to check if there is some question? Do you have
that was pretty much, but
okay.
I think we have a question.
Okay.
Regarding
maybe something we can announce also during with webinar. I saw there is a question, but
yeah.
Before
okay.
Something we missed in this presentation, it's now with Speos. We have the capability also to calculate UGR coefficient.
Ah, you're right. Sorry
yeah.
About that. Yes,
so,
I forgot to mention that. Exactly.
Okay, so maybe for those who are interested by UGR, so you can keep in mind, so now it's available, so it's something you can calculate. So static UGR or you can have the table?
You can have a table, again, working with the IES, you can specify the distribution of your different luminaires, the configuration of your room. And get the UGR table. So that's the standard.
Okay, so output of the simulation on top of Illuminance IRS would be the UGR table.
Yes,
okay.
Exactly.
And here, what you want to show us?
What I would like to show you is a simulation we did inside a corridor where we have different luminaires, and we want to actually simulate, calculate the UGR value.
So here we see that the new functionality will give us directly the luminaires,
yes.
The UGR value for this specific situation.
Exactly.
So we have the table and we have the dedicated coefficient for a specific position in a specific environment.
Exactly.
Okay, cool. So great. Okay.
Yes.
So we go to the question. So we have a question about the material in your simulation. So yes, so we spoke about library of components, reflector, LED, lenses, etc. But what about material? So do we have some specific functionality?
That's a real good question. When you simulate light, your simulation is good enough with respect to the data you put inside your system, your mockup.
Okay.
And so the idea is to be as close as possible to reality. And to do so, I have a slide actually regarding these points. Okay, so to do so, we actually achieve characterization of the optical surfaces, but also the optical material using our own measurement device.
Okay.
So we are able to characterize diffusing materials such as, you know, the milky, the
okay.
plastic.
Okay, which is more and more used, especially
yes.
for interior lighting in order to
diffuse light.
To diffuse the light, okay.
But also, also the different roughness you can have on metals or on plastics,
okay.
also to diffuse light again.
Okay.
And also, the second point, which is quite interesting, is also the capabilities to actually replicate hundreds of millions times the same basic pattern in order to replicate diffusing films or,
okay.
or even declaring films.
Okay, like we see here,
like this example here.
Film
on
can be simulated. Okay. Okay, perfect. Any other question? No. So now we will switch to the next part. So just to sum up. So first we have defined together the specification in the street, so we know which level of light, color, power we expect. Then in this second part, we saw how speos can help to speed up the development process and to improve the lighting performance of the luminaire. So now we have a luminaire, but instead of to spend some money and some time to create a virtual prototyping, we have also a tool set in order to experience, so based on virtual prototyping, the luminaire. So is mainly dedicated for the product and marketing people and also for the test and validation people in order to make relevant decisions about the design. So the first one, it's thanks to the Optis HPC solution, so high power calculation. When you develop a luminaire in your CAD environment, like we saw before with Etienne, so it remains only one click because you have defined optical properties, you have positioned the source. With only one click and HPC, you can produce such rendering, lit and lit appearance. So here it's not picture, but it's renderings of the luminaire. So again, if you want to promote or if you want to make some relevant decision about the style of your luminaire, as soon as you have designed a part, you can produce the unlit or lit appearance of your luminaire, like I told before, in order to make a decision about homogeneity, to make a decision about style, or also in order to bring to your potential customer or to your customer a first picture, a first rendering of the luminaire, in order to help to sell sooner without to spend time and money in the prototyping. Okay.
So is it lit and lit capability? And especially now we have HPC, so it's very fast calculation.
Now we'll go in another world. It's the experience of the lighting condition, lighting scenario, lighting architecture. We have developed a luminaire, we have validated the performance, but now we can go in the virtual world. So for Light and Building 2018, we did with Almeco a virtual show. So what you see here, it's virtual. It has been done, with Almeco for Light and Building. I will go to the immersive simulation. So here, it's a simulation. It's a 360 degree pre-calculated simulation with the real light condition. So if we look, here we have some spots. These spots are linked to some specific luminaire, we can see here. But now, you can experience, you can have a full virtual experience, a virtual tour in this shop, where you can change the location, you can see different areas, and you can also switch to false color in order to see where you put some light, what are the levels of light to some specific areas. So, again, it can be used for it can be used to make decisions about the performance, but it can also be used to promote your capability to put the good light at the right area. So it's what we did with Almeco, and
already
most important, it can be used here in a portable device. Like I told you, it's a pre-calculated, and after it has been pushed on an HTML file. So you can play it on any laptop, tablet, phone, iPhone, etc. And after here, like we see, you can visualize in a cardboard, in a 3D environment, you can visualize those aspects. So which is for the pre-calculated possibility. And now we will switch to another capability, it's the real time. So Cédric will come back in the HMD, but here you see it's typically the same software we saw at the beginning when we do the live painting. We have also the capacity to put some libraries, some luminaire in libraries. We have the possibility to bring it in the 3D scene and to move it in real time to choose the right position, the right power, the right color, the right distance between two luminaires. So again, sorry, it's collaborative. You and your customer or the end user and the provider of luminaire can discuss together and can validate some positioning or some choice of luminaire together thanks to this solution. So we will go in the HMD. So this solution is scalable, it can be deployed on a cave, so a full virtual environment with several faces, etc. It can be deployed on power wall or a large TV, so you can be sit all together around the TV and make your validation and decision together, but also in a HMD. So it's what we will see right now with Cédric again. So here it's what Cédric is able to visualize, and here we have the same. So here you can create your own scenario. You can put your customer in the HMD, and you can submit it with several scenarios. So here, we are in the first lighting scenario. Of course, here you see we have a limited space, but Cédric could walk, he can move, he can turn, so everything is done in real time. He could take also a luminaire and change the position in real time, etc. So what I will show you here, it's the capability to switch from a configuration to another configuration. So I will switch from luminaire number 2, and here Cédric will directly see how is the lighting scenario with luminaire number 2, or with luminaire number 1. Number 2. You prefer number 2?
This one.
Okay, number 1, this one. And also, of course, you can switch to false color, you can switch to true color, to illuminance or luminance level. You can also make some simulation or glare effect in order to really visualize your scene, your scenario, like it will be perceived by the end customer. So here, again, you can speed up the decision. You can give access to a library of luminaire, and you can let him choose which luminaire he wants and where he wants to place it. So typically, here if I take one luminaire and I move it, in real time I can move it, I can change its position, and I can also define, I can create together with my customer the best scenario. I will switch to a last possibility. The smart lighting. So give me 2 seconds. Okay.
You did it.
Yeah, I will show you. So here you can see that the street is not illuminated, and we have also the capacity to create some dynamic scenario. So here you see that when I come close to the luminaire, it switches. When I move further, it switches off. If I turn here, you see behind me the luminaire is switched off. After I go here, and now another one is a switched off. So how we did that? So we not bring only light in this scenario, but we also define some sensor position and some sensor sensitivity area. So and as soon as I enter in the sensitivity area of my presence detector, the light switch off. So it means we can create some smart lighting scenario with not only the luminaire, but also with the camera, with the detectors. So now you can bring life in your project, so you can add some sensor. If you can play the movie, please. Okay, so you can add some sensor, you can add some vision with some algorithm of detection, you can add any environmental components in order to promote, in order to educate, or to define some smart lighting scenario, but also in order to experience some different situations. Here we see a car, we can think about using our solution also to evaluate what should be the good dimming of light. So what should be the good level of light against the density of car? You can check if you position the luminaire at a specific position, if it can glare the driver. So you can have the experience and you can adapt the smart city scenario with these virtual scenario evaluation capabilities.
Excellent.
So it was a quick overview of the different possibilities. So again, imagine where you can create together with the prescriber and the designer the specification. Then you can design, so it's development and optimization of the lighting feature and the luminaire. And at the end, you can experience. You can experience the visualization of a single luminaire, but you can also experience the luminaire in its whole environment in a specific scenario, from static to smart city scenarios.
Excellent. Thank you very much. I think we are a little late, but I hope people are still attending. We have a question, Julien.
Okay.
And it's time for question and answer. So.
Okay. So is there any design and optimization templates for special scenarios, for example, street lighting, tunnel lighting, etc.? So yes, in Speos, you have the capability to import or the capability to define some measurement templates. So it means on any result, you can have some automated analysis.
Okay.
So link to some regulation and some templates. And all those parameters, all those these measurement points in Speos can be put in an optimization loop. So it means you can put together in this loop mechanical and optical parameters to reach some specific photometric targets. And these photometric targets, of course, can be linked to the regulations.
Marvelous. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
How I can define targets for street lighting?
How can I define target for street lighting? So for street lighting, it depends what you mean by street lighting. So it's maybe something we should details. But usually for the street lighting, first we take care about the illuminance. Second, we take care about the luminance and also to the glare effect. So yes, all those aspects are some output of the simulation. So can be put in an optimization loop. So how to do that, if you want to see it, we can create some dedicated demonstration, but again, it's easy to use the environment, so by drag and drop and drag and drop some measurement areas in the loop, it can be done.
Okay, there is another question, but it's not the right webinar to answer the question. Yeah.
Okay.
Optical films.
Okay, so this one we
degearing and
Etienne already answered to the degearing thing and the other question.
Okay.
Like with the 3D texture, virtual 3D texture capability, we can define accurately such a film, not with simple surface definition, but with a complex light propagation in the micro elements, which is quite a unique capability.
I think there is a question 6, no? No? Okay.
Okay.
Well, thank you very much for attending this webinar. We are a little late, but it's the first time we deliver the webinar this way. I mean, live in YouTube. And I hope you understand that you will be kind with us. Thank you, Julien, for your explanation and all that. The products that are working and you showed today. Thank you, Etienne, also. Hope to talk to you soon. Please contact Julien directly.
Yes, so please, if you have any question about the different steps, the different product or capability you saw, I will be very pleased to keep some time to give you some dedicated presentation and demonstration.
And meet
and
different people all over the world. Thank you very much. Have a brilliant day. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.